All right, Levers Automotive again. Got a couple things going on here. Got the fenders almost ready to get pulled off. Got the whole core support out from the whole front end. Got the hood off already. We got another video that we uploaded on removing that.
They gave us a nice head start because all the frame, it's all cleaned up.
Yeah, yeah, you the know? Frame actually is
look,
pretty good shape.
These did look good.
You know.
But I was actually thinking of trying to clean these up, but look at that.
Yeah, that's what I saw when we were getting it pulled.
These are so cheap, man. We could just buy these and put just put new ones, man.
Yeah, this was kind of hitting where you couldn't really tell that that was all rusted up from
But the fenders are definitely new though.
They core support being on there, but that those are the type of things that we're talking about when it comes to you don't know what you're going to replace up until you start stripping it. So this is why you cannot give an estimate for jobs like this. Luckily, this is our truck. We bought this one. It's going to be the shop truck. So no problem here.
Hood hinges and stuff. But it's overall super clean, man.
Yeah, it's a good truck. I'm very satisfied with it.
My main concern right now is get the frame cleaned up. Get the frame, clean it all up to get it inspected. And then what I want to do is reinforce it a little bit if we can.
Yeah.
If you can.
Yeah, we're gonna
add
some strength to those frames so that way it won't be flexing and moving, and when you lift it up it ain't gonna tweak it around.
All the original fuel lines, all that, we're gonna delete all that and just put PTFE fuel hoses, probably like -8 or -6. A fuel return system, not just a returnless. We'll do it like the LS, the single return, but in the back we'll make it where it returns back there with the filter, you know.
Yeah, so
we won't put a fuel regulator up front, but we'll just leave it just like the stock LS have it, and then we'll just do the return in the back, and then just put a fuel pump assembly like I'll build my own up. Depending on how the tank is in the back, we can retro the tank, the fuel pump assembly, and just put in like an F-body one. Put a brand new one in there and just make it all. It's all built in. The fuel pump regulator is in the fuel pump assembly already, so that makes it super easy. And it makes it very reliable versus the fuel pumps and the setups that you do on the outside of the on the frame rails, external pumps. So just running it in, and it's got its own baffle too. That's why I like using that, because if you can get that to work, you know, it's just like you're running a factory setup in just an old stuff. So it makes it very nice.
Yeah, so that's just part of some of the plans that we're doing. That's, you know, we got a lot of things that we're going to take care of, but tonight we're getting this motor and transmission pulled out, so we're going to still go ahead and get the fenders off.
He's got the original, or I don't know if it's original, but the 350 transmission in there.
Yeah,
he's a junk, but we'll probably just put a 4060e.
Yeah, we don't.
It blows up.
Yeah, we don't really care for the 4060s, but we're going to keep it simple on it. Normally, we always
Swap it later.
Everybody knows we always go with the T56s, but this route, we're just going to go with a 4L60 for now because we got one laying around, so we're going to put that in. We're going to pull this 5.7 out and put a 5.3
and put the 4L. The 6L80E, we could put it in here, and I could put the 6L90 in the Bandit.
Yeah.
You know, we could even have done that, but that'll be kind of later down the line. We could always pull the transmissions out and redo it. But those 6L80Es, they require the E38 ECU. And that just takes the whole thing in a different direction where we're just like, we'd rather replace 5 4L60Es spend more money and more time into it, really. I'd rather just leave it like that. If not, if anything, if I want a 6-speed, we'd just put a real T56 or something in it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we could always convert it. If we get tired of that 4L60 crapping out on us, we're going to just swap it.
I don't plan on hot riding. As long as you can tow whatever, you know, obviously it's nicer with the 6-speed automatics, but it's just a come in and go in and out deal. As fast as possible, it's still gonna be a nice short truck though.
Yeah.
And obviously we gotta get, I wanna put AC in it, so it's just, we either gotta buy the original AC box or just get it like a vintage setup and just put an aftermarket AC in there. Which I'm thinking that might be the way to go. But right now I just wanna do burnouts.
Yeah. All right guys, you heard it. We're next video you're gonna see the fenders off, and then we'll be starting the engine job to remove it. So we'll be doing it tonight. I'll have the future bosses coming in. My two boys are coming in after I have their mother dropping them off after school, which they should be showing up any minute. So they'll be coming in the video next. All right, guys, we'll see you soon. Don't forget, like and subscribe.